number seven. Hey. A fun side story to this whole Anthony Davis Lakers speculation is the involvement of Lonzo Ball, who could be part of the package leaving LA to bring Davis in. And even though no one asked, of course, Lavar Ball had things to say, telling reporters he didn't want Lonzo going to New Orleans and that he was going to speak into existence him ending up in Phoenix. The prop, will or won't Lavar Ball speak into existence Lonzo going to Phoenix?
First of all, I just want to say yuck.
Yeah, I know.
I just want to say yuck about this whole situation, but I hope Big Baller likes the Big Easy, because that's where Lonzo's going to be headed, all right? Listen, he's nothing more than a third wheel on this team. I get it. He is a good, solid ball player, but he's not worth making a big stink over, and LaVar Ball should take over as the most annoying pro's father in the history of the NBA. He'll be selling Big Baller beads on Bourbon Street, I'm sure. Look, it's a great move, and it makes sense. I know he'd rather see him in Phoenix, but that's not going to happen, and that's not where I think Lonzo belongs anyway, if this trade does go through. So he's not going to wish anything into existence except for another pair of overpriced, ugly shoes and annoying press when he doesn't deserve it, when his three sons are the ones that we should be paying attention to.
Well,
so no.
I can't believe he's even speaking anything into existence right now, the fact that he's in Lithuania. He's probably just creating more of a travel ban for a country that we don't have a travel ban for. But I do think, I mean, he already spoke into existence, Lonzo getting to the Lakers. So I see it as this, I mean, the squeaky wheel gets the grease, right? And he constantly won't shut up. And it's almost like people give him what he wants just so he will shut up.
Yeah.
So I don't see him not going to Phoenix. I think it's possible. And I mean, he wants to be closer to LA. This is where the rest of his family is. I think Phoenix makes that easier for him. I think he wants to be closer to he has a baby, at least one that we know of. So he has one here.
They all have babies.
Yeah, they all have it. Yeah. So I think he wants to be here. And like I said, NBA players now have more power than NFL players. So I think that he can make that happen if that's really what he wants.
Yeah, yeah.
I know.
He's going to New Orleans. He's going to go. And you know what? Big Baller Brand can't fight that. He can't fight. He willed it in existence because he knew the Lakers wanted someone like him and they needed him. They needed a bunch of young guys. But that kid's gone. The kid is gone.
Bye. No.
He'll be gone.
Yeah. That was a tough argument to have to take the yes. positive side of. So yes. A point for effort, but
two points for the argument. All right, I'll take it.
What did LeBron do to get LaVar to mostly stop saying creepy things all the time?
I think he probably,
just,
had,
I don't wonder.
Yeah. Probably had to sit down with him, have a real honest conversation, and be like, listen, man, you're really diluting what's important here. I think
he just put some like Dimetapp in his Coca-Cola every time he sits down, so he's just a little sweepy.
LaVar doesn't drink Dimetapp.
too tired.
I could drink Dimetapp. Be fine. I'd still beat Michael Jordan one-on-one. This guy had the nerve to say he'd beat Michael
and
Jordan
Ice
in his
Cube
prime.
Too, right?
Yeah.
Wow.
He thought he could beat Michael Jordan in his prime one-on-one. Yeah. I mean, the delusions of grandeur is remarkable.
I could beat Floyd Mayweather in a boxing match.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sure you could. Well, let's see it. Yeah. I'll put money
in. I would love to watch that.
I would love to watch
Dana White, get these guys in the ring somehow. Let's watch that go down. Big ball of fights. He'd probably make a billion on that.
Somebody needs to beat the shit out of that guy. That's how these things get handled.
It's going to be Gothard.